Oh, today is a bit dark because it was raining very heavy, and well, maybe I'll change the lighting so you can, you know, make it light on the video because it's really dark. Anyway, it's only 4:30. All right, I wanted to give you a couple of updates with regards to the Middle East job market. Now, lately, it has started off from the past 2-3 months that people who were laid off, people who lost their jobs, or they were told, sorry, you have to discontinue from a couple of months ago, now are being called back. And in some cases, like I'd put the poll on my community page, one guy, very senior position, here he was working for this multi-billion dollar company in UAE. It's run by a very rich Arab family. So he worked with them for, you know, 20-25 years. Started from right below, grew up to a very senior position. Now they terminated him because obviously pandemic and recession. Now what happened was, he got in touch with me later on, you know, took my services. He used to follow my YouTube channel here and there. So he tried for 6 or 8 months. He couldn't get any job. In desperation, he called me. And he's a family guy. He has children, he has wife, he has bills to pay. He was skeptical. He didn't know whether what I would do would work. I have obviously charged him a premium because he was at a senior level. So we worked on his profile, we worked on his interview skills, on his sell ability, you know, because he never had to sell himself. His work always did the talking, but now in a competitive landscape, you have to sell yourself. Finally, it was not easy. Okay, let me tell you, it was not easy because he was at a senior level. Worked on it for, worked together for 2 months. That is after making the resume rebrand. We worked together for another 2 months. Finally, he got 2 job offers. And he asked me which one to take. I suggested for him to go. There was a startup as well as there was a slightly established company. The slightly established company was paying him a little lesser. The startup was paying him a little bit more. I told him go for the established company, even though it was kind of the, you know, it was low. So where he was earning, let's say 100, startup company offered him say 90, this other company offered him 85. So I told him go for the 85. Okay, just give you an example so you understand. Now he has been working with them for a couple of months. He's happy, he's at a senior level, we are still in touch. He sent me a message, you know, some time ago, and he said, Aloy, the old company where I used to work for, they've called me back. Now, because COVID, they've managed to overcome, the Middle East market is opening up. They've asked me to come back, and as a compensation, they're giving me a joining bonus. On top of that, they are giving me like a 35 to 50% increase in my salary. So before he was getting 100, now he's going to get 150, imagine. Not only cash, but with other benefits, schooling for children, insurance, you know, all these other benefits. So he asked me, Loy, I was getting 100, now I'm getting 85. Should I go for 150? Because it's nearly double, and that's a very big thing, you know. It's not a small thing. See, because in the Middle East, if you're an expat and you're at the tail end of your career, just you have another 10 more years, like 50 to 60, you have 10 more years. Isn't it better to make the maximum money? So he was confused. He told me, Loy, I'm pretty divided. My friends are saying, go ahead. My wife is saying, don't go. I value your opinion. You tell me what, because you think logically and whatever. Okay, so what I told him is very simple. I told him very simple. Okay, I gave him this example. And the reason I'm giving you this example is because in case you get a job offer from your old company, what should you do? Now, first things first, if you don't have a job at all and your old company is calling you back, grab it. But if you have a job, if you already have another job, okay, then keep this in mind. Let's assume you are in a relationship. You have a girlfriend of 20 years together. And when you go through hardships, she dumps you. And now you're left without money, without anything, and your girlfriend also has left you. And then you get this other girl who takes you in when you're the poorest of your poor. And she is with you. And now, when you become successful, that girl, old girlfriend, calls you back and says, "Hey, come back, I love you again." Do you think you would recommend anyone to go back? So when I asked him, they said, no fucking way, man. She was never there for me when I needed her the most. Exactly. Same thing with your job. These people were ready to kick you out when times were bad. Now times are good, they'll take you back again. So that is one. The second point I asked him to think. Let's assume you get double the salary, but you'll be working with them for only 2 years, and then they'll dump you again and you'll be unemployed. Are you comfortable living with the fact that you'll earn double the salary, but then you'll be unemployed again? He said, "No, Loy, I can't take the stress. The stress of not being without a job, the embarrassment of going and applying for jobs. It was a very tough pill to swallow, and even if they're going to pay me 3 times, I wouldn't go back that way, because I want a job where I can focus on my work and plan out my transition." So I told him, yes, same thing. So if they take you back, there's no guarantee that they'll throw you out again, because this has happened. In some companies, they give you the job back and then they say, "Oh, sorry, it's not working out." The third one, I told him, the third reason is, see, when you undergo stress, no, it's not just you, it's your spouse, it's your children, it's your family, it's your loved ones. Everybody goes through stress. And though they may not say it, it is a terrible time to go through. I said, for example, I told him, when I'm sick, it's not just me who is sick and broken and worried. My wife is really worried, and my baby also can feel it. I said, when you are without your job and you are stressed and worried, your wife may not show it, but she felt it. And in some cases, you know, what's worse is if your health doesn't support you, then you're bad to worse, man. And I said, the reason why your friends are saying go, because they think commercially. But the reason why your wife is saying no is because she knows your pain. And she went through it. And she doesn't want you to go through it, nor does she want to go through it. But more so you. So he said, "Yeah, Loy, that's right." So end of the day, I told him this. I want you to think of it as, let's assume you'll get double the salary, but after 1 year or 2 years, they'll throw you out at any point of time. If that is okay with you, go ahead and take the job. If that is not okay with you, stick with the same. And lo and behold, after 24 hours or so, he called me and said, "Well, I've decided to stay with this same job." See, the reason I wanted to share this topic with you is because now the market is opening up. Many people who are laid off are now being called back. And some people, because they don't have an option, or they don't have any, if you don't have any option, grab that. But if you do have an option and you have moved on with your life, don't go back. Because going back is like, the biblical saying, there is a biblical saying that says, a dog was given good food, he ate, ran outside, then vomited. After vomiting, it ran away, but then it came back and was again looking back at its vomit and thinking, "Should I eat that?" There are some dogs who do that, which I feel pukish. I've seen that. But then there are those who say, "No, it's done, forget it." Be it a relationship, be it a friendship, be it anything. Once it's over, move on. The people who stick on or go back to something that is broken and all that. The only reason they do that is because they don't have a choice. So my sincere recommendation to you is, if you have lost your job and you don't have one and they have called you back, go. But remember, you can lose your job again. The second one is, obviously, if you lost your job and they call you back, but now they are giving you a revised salary, ask yourself, do you want to go back in your career in terms of your earnings? And, you know, that is nobody's fault but yours, because you have not upgraded yourself in terms of sell ability and marketability. Because remember, the world is your oyster. There is someone out there who is ready to pay a bit more. It all takes a strategy. Everything takes a strategy. And last if not the least, if you already have a job and it's offering you security and stability, ask yourself what is important. Volatility, but high pay, or security and long term. I would any day go for the latter, especially when you have a family, especially when you have other people depending on you, and especially when your age has crossed a certain threshold. So this is what I have to say to you. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. It's me signing off. You guys take care.